Hi folks, Will from MinIO here, and in this video we're going to be discussing identity and access management with your MinIO server. Identity and access management, very important. This is how you control access to your objects on your MinIO server. And the identity portion of it is actually a variable. You can use MinIO's built-in IDP, or you can use LDAP or Active Directory. You can even use OpenID to manage the identity piece. But the access management, that's all done via policies. We have policy-based access control, and all of those policies are going to be managed in MinIO. So let's take a look at what we're going to be talking about today. So we're going to be talking about our policies. We'll show you how to create a policy. You can create one from scratch. There's also some built-ins. We're also going to be talking about the MinIO IDP, how you can set up users and groups. And then we'll move on to talking about LDAP and OpenID and how you can replace the MinIO IDP service with your own so that you can have single sign-on. And if your company mandates that you use LDAP or OpenID, you can use that. So let's go ahead and dive right into our policies here. So with MinIO, you have policy-based access control. And what this means is that an authenticated user is going to have authorized actions. Now, MinIO is going to manage this policy. Even if we move to another authentication system, the policy is still managed by MinIO, and that's very important. This is going to default to deny. So if you have a user with no policy, they can't actually do anything. They can't look at buckets, they can't look at objects, they can't do any changes to the server. Basically, no policy means no operations can be performed because you have this default deny. The policy-based access control in MinIO is compatible with AWS IAM policies, which means that if you are used to setting up AWS policies, it's very easy to migrate those over to MinIO. And keep in mind, if I have a deny and an allow on the same task, it's going to use deny as the override. It's always going to default to deny. Okay? Very important to keep in mind. So we do have some built-in policies that are available the moment you fire up your MinIO server. You have console admin has full access. Think of this as like your root user. This console admin can make changes to the server. They can do anything that you want to do as a root user on the system. We also have read-only, which allows you to get specific objects, but it has no listing permissions. It's literally just get some buckets, get some objects, and you have to know the whole path to that object, including all of the prefixes, anything else in there, because there's no way to list. Read-write can read and write all objects and buckets. This does have list capabilities included. And we also have this write-only, which can put objects in a bucket that already exists. Okay, you can't create buckets, but you can put objects. The diagnostics tool is generally used just for some subnet access. So that is a tool just for specific users. And you can view all the policies with MC admin policy list. Let's go ahead and take a look at that. So I've actually already set up an alias talking to a demo server. And if I want to do this MC admin policy list, and my alias is called demo, what I get back out is there are my built-ins: diagnostics, read-only, read-write, write-only, and console admin. So you can always list your policies using this policy list. So the built-in policies are already there for you to use, but they may be a little too restrictive or permissive. For instance, that read-only policy does not allow you to list anything. So you might want to create your own policy that does some extra work for you. So the easiest way to do this is to start with an existing policy. I like to start with the read-only policy. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to do an MC policy info. And when you do the MC policy info, you're going to get all of the information about the policy. You're going to get the fact that it's policy, it's got a name, it's got some other stuff. But this policy file flag just puts the policy details into a file. Then I can edit that JSON file, add more permissions, whatever I need to do, and create a new policy using that JSON. So it's very, very easy to do. There's a bunch of different supported policy actions. They're all documented right there on that link. You can go and take a look at those, but there's tons of different actions. It's all policies that are compatible with AWS. So your AWS policies can be migrated very easily as well. Let's take a look at this example. So we're going to use one of our built-in policies. We're going to use that read-only policy. So MC admin, again, policy, MC admin policy. This is what we're going to be doing a lot of here. So we're going to do an info. And if I do my demo alias and I use my read only, what I get back is the policy name and the policy. Now, could I use this to write a new policy? Absolutely, but I need to do some editing. I got to get rid of the policy name. I got to get rid of the policy flag. I got to remove a couple of pairs of brackets there. So instead of doing that, I'm going to do the exact same command one more time, and I'm going to say policy file, new JSON. Okay. And this is going to write just the policy portion to that new JSON. Now, notice it still outputs the full thing, but if I open new JSON for editing, there we go. It's just the policy. So I've got my version, I've got a simple statement here, and I've got an allow. Now remember, it's going to deny anything that I don't explicitly allow, so I don't have to worry about putting a bunch of deny statements in here. But what I am going to do is I am going to add one more function here. I'm going to say S3 list star. And this is going to allow my user to list anything that they want to see on the server. So if they don't know where the actual bucket lives, they can now do a list. They can get some information. They can see the list of buckets. They can see the objects that are in the buckets. It's just a very simple change. And that's all that I'm going to do here. Now notice, there's no policy name here. So I'm going to set my own policy name when I send this back up. So I'm going to do an MC admin policy create, and this is on demo. And my new policy name is going to be read list. We'll just call it read list. And new.json is my policy file. So I'm going to go ahead and run that. There we go. I've now created this read list policy successfully. If I do an MC admin policy list on demo, there is my read list is now part of this. If I do an MC admin policy info demo on read list, now I get my entire policy back out. So I have my get object, I have my S3 list, and I have my get bucket location. So now this user, any user that uses this particular policy, will be able to not only get objects, but also list them. Now let's say you want to remove a policy. Any policy that you've created can be removed. Built-in policies, it may look like they can be removed, but they cannot. Okay, they do not get removed. So do take care when you're using this command. Do be sure to check and make sure the policy was removed. And to remove a policy, it's simply MC admin policy remove, give it the alias and the policy name that you want to remove in your set. Now, it may be better than deleting a policy to simply disassociate the policy from any users and groups that are using it. And the MC admin policy entities command will show you all of the entities that are associated with a given policy, all the users and groups, and then you simply detach the users and groups from that policy. That's probably a better way to manage it anyway. But let's go ahead and take a look at removing a policy. So let me show you this. I'm going to go ahead and do the MC admin policy list on demo one more time. And you can see there, we still have our read list, read only, our read write, we have diagnostics. Now let's say we want to remove the diagnostics one, MC admin policy remove demo diagnostics. It says that it removed it successfully, but if I do the list one more time, it's still there. Okay, so I haven't actually removed it. Still there. So let's, instead of removing diagnostics, let's remove our read list that we created. That one says it's been successfully removed. And now if we list it, there it is, it's gone. So I cannot remove the built-in ones, even though it says I did, but I can remove ones that I have created. Now remember, since I just created this locally, I can recreate this. I still have the new.json file and I can recreate this very easily should I need to. But this allows you to remove a policy that you are no longer interested in maintaining. Again, generally speaking, I would probably just use that policy entities and detach the policy from any users. That way I'm not having to recreate policies later on down the road. Just a little easier. We're going to take a break right here, and in our next video, we're going to talk about how you can use MinIO IDP to manage your users and groups and then assign policies to them. If you'd like to reach out with us about this video or any other topic, you can always reach us using any of the methods you see here on the screen. You can also chat with us interactively on slack.min.io or just leave a comment here on the video. Thanks, and we'll see you for MinIO IDP.